If you are first time watching my channel, do subscribe, activate bell icon and select all option to get more chemistry videos like this. Hello everyone, today I am going to explain what is electron affinity. Atoms of some elements gain electrons while forming ionic compounds. Means some elements, while they are forming ionic compounds, they always try to take the electrons from the other atoms. Example, 7th group elements. If you take chlorine, so it has 7 valency electrons in the outermost shell. That's why it requires one more electron to get octet configuration. That's why it always try to take one electron. An atom is able to gain an electron only when the electron outside the atom is attracted by the nucleus. Means if you take any atom, if the nucleus of that atom is trying to attract the electrons which are there in that atom, then it can able to attract the electrons of other atom also. Attraction involves the liberation of energy. Means always attraction of electrons release some amount of energy. Means it indicates the exothermic process. The energy liberated when an electron is added to its neutral gaseous atom is called an electron affinity of an element. Means if you take any atom which is a neutral state and which is in gaseous form, whenever an electron is added to that atom, then it will release some amount of energy which is known as electron affinity. See this diagram here. In K shell, 2 electrons are there. In L shell, 2 more electrons are there. And if one more electron is trying to be added to that atom, then what happens? Some amount of energy will be released by that atom. The energy is generally known as electron affinity or electron gain enthalpy. Electron affinity of an element is also called electron gain enthalpy. So electron affinity is also, we can also call it as electron gain enthalpy. The energy liberated when first electron is added to the outermost orbit or shell of a neutral gaseous atom is called its first electron affinity. Means if we try to add one electron to the atom, if it is the first electron, then it will release amount of energy. Now that energy is particularly known as first electron affinity. Here if we take this example, M is an atom which is there in gaseous state. If we add one electron to this atom, then it will become M minus anion and it will release amount of energy which is given in this equation as E1. So here M is nothing but element, E1 is nothing but first electron affinity. Means here amount of energy released whenever first electron is added to the atom is known as first electron affinity. The energy liberated when an electron is added to the outermost orbit or shell of a uninegative ion of the element is called its second electron affinity. Means if you take any uninegative ion, means minus one, the ion which is having minus one charge, if you try to add one more electron to the uninegative ion, means anion, then it will also release amount of extra energy which is generally called as second electron affinity. If we take this example, M minus is nothing but uninegative ion. If we add one more electron, it becomes M minus 2 and release amount of energy E2, where E2 is known as second electron affinity. Practically, no element shows liberation of energy when the second electron is added to its uninegative ion. Means theoretically, second electron addition may be possible, but practically, second electron addition is not possible because whenever one electron is added to the neutral atom, it becomes negative ion. Already it is negative. If we try to add one more electron, so there are some repulsions between the negative ion and the electron. That's why second electron cannot be added to the uninegative ion easily. It does not mean that dinegative or trinegative ions do not form. Means can't we get a dinegative ion which is having minus 2 charge or trinegative ion which is having minus 3 charge? That is possible, but in another way. They do form, but for adding second electron, energy in another way like bond formation must be given. Means second electron addition is also possible, but some amount of energy should be given to the electron to overcome the repulsions which are there between negative charge and the electron. So that extra energy is given to that anion in the form of energy which is released by the bond formation. If we observe this table, in this table electron affinity values in kilojoules are given for the 7th A group elements and 6th A group elements. Here in these two groups, you may observe that electron affinity values are decreased
in A group, except
in case of first and second element in every group. See, here fluorine is having minus 328 kilojoule for mole electron affinity, whereas chlorine is having minus 349. Here electron affinity value is increased from fluorine to chlorine. Same thing is observed in case of oxygen and sulfur. Here the question is, in these two groups electron affinity values are decreased, but why in case of first two elements it is violated? The second period element, example fluorine, has less electron affinity than the third period element of the same group, example chlorine 5. This is because fluorine atom is smaller in size than chlorine atom. F2 is also having strong inter-electronic repulsions overcome at the expense of a part of the energy liberated, hence the overall energy liberated is less than that of chlorine atom. Means comparatively fluorine atom is very very small in size compared to the chlorine atom. And one more thing, in fluorine, so inter-electronic repulsions are there because each fluorine having 3 electron pairs. That's why there are some repulsions between the electron pairs of 2 fluorine atoms. Hence, the overall energy liberated is less than that of the chlorine atom. Means here some of the energy is used to overcome the inter-electronic repulsions. That's why energy liberated is very very less compared to chlorine. Electron affinity values decrease in a group and increase in a period. Means if you take electron affinity value, so if you move from top to bottom in a group, it will decrease. And if you move from left to right in a period, that electron affinity value will increase. All the factors which influence the ionization energy would also influence the electron affinity. Means those factors which will influence the ionization energy. So I already explained what are the factors influence the ionization energy in the previous video in my channel. Just go and see that video. And those factors which also influence the electron affinity. Metals have very low electron affinity values, and alkaline earth metals have even positive values. If you take any metal, so electron affinity value is very very less, because metals will always try to lose the electrons, they won't try to take the electrons. One more thing, alkaline earth metals means secondary group elements, so even they have positive values. The negative sign for energy value indicates that energy is liberated or lost. Means here sometimes it comes negative value, so that negative value indicates that energy is released or liberated or lost in the process. The positive sign tells that the energy is gained or absorbed. So that positive value indicates that energy is absorbed or taken or gained in that process. The calculated electron affinity values for alkaline earth metals, secondary group, and noble gases, eighth group, are positive 5. So if we take the electron affinity values of secondary group elements, means alkaline earth metals and noble gas, eighth group elements, they have positive values. Electron affinity values are positive for them. So why? What is the reason for this? Due to completely filled S up shell in alkaline earth metals, secondary group, and completely filled valence shell, that is octet, in the noble gases, eighth group, they are highly stable. Hence, energy is required to add an electron. That is, their electron gain enthalpy values are positive. Means here, if we take secondary group elements, they are in that. Already S block subshell is completely filled. If you take 8th group elements, already their valence shell, means NS2NP6, is completely filled. That's why, so they are highly stable. That's why they won't try to take any electron. That's why they have positive electron gain enthalpy values. Next, electronegativity. What is the definition of electronegativity? The electronegativity of an element is defined as the relative tendency of its atom to attract electrons towards itself when it is bonded to the atom of another element. Means here, if you take any element, if it is connected with any other element, the tendency to attract the electrons, bonded electrons, towards it is known as the electronegativity of that particular element. All the factors that influence the ionization energy and the electron affinity of elements influence the electronegativity values of those elements. Means here, already we have seen some factors in ionization energy, so those factors will also influence the electron affinity values and also electronegativity values. Because of this, Millikan proposed that the electronegativity of an element is the average value of its ionization energy and electron affinity. Means here electronegativity is equals to ionization energy plus electron affinity by 2. Means here electronegativity is the average of the ionization energy plus electron affinity. Pauling assigned the electronegativity En values for elements on the basis of bond energies. He assumed that the electronegativity of hydrogen is 2.20 and calculated the electronegativity values of other elements with respect to hydrogen. The scientist Pauling, so he was the first scientist who assigned the electronegativity values for the elements on the basis of their bond energies. What is the meaning of bond energy? The energy required to break the bond whenever an element is connected with another element is known as bond energy of that particular element. And he successfully calculated the electronegativity value of hydrogen as 2.20, and based on that electronegativity value of hydrogen atom, he able to calculate the electronegativity values of other elements. If you see this table, so there one group means 7th A group halogen family is given, and one period, second period, is given. So if you observe the electronegativity values of elements decrease in a group and increase along a period. Means if you take electronegativity values, when we move from top to bottom in a group, electronegativity values decrease. When we move from left to right in a period, electronegativity values increases. The most electronegative element is fluorine, and the least electronegative stable element is cesium. So if we take the periodic table, so in that most electronegative element is fluorine, and the least negative stable element is cesium. Next, metallic and non-metallic properties. Metals are electropositive elements. Means if you take any metal, they always have electropositive nature. Electropositive nature means tendency to lose the electrons. In compounds, they generally show a tendency to remain as positive ions. Means metals always try to be there in the form of positive ions only. They always try to lose one electron and try to become as positive ions. Non-metals are generally more electronegative due to their smaller atomic radii. So if you take any non-metal, so here electronegativity values of non-metals is very high. Electronegativity is very high and electropositivity is very less for the non-metals because size is very small for them. Metallic character decreases while non-metallic character increases as we move along a period from left to right. When we move from left to right in a period, in any period, so metallic character decreases whereas non-metallic character increases. If you see this example, third period, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. Here sodium, magnesium are metals, aluminium, silicon are semi-metals or metalloids, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine are non-metals. Metallic character increases while non-metallic character decreases as we move from top to bottom in a group. Means if you take any group, when you move from top to bottom in a group, metallic character increases while non-metallic character decreases. If you take this example, 4th A group, carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead. While we are moving from top to bottom, carbon is a non-metal, silicon, germanium, metalloids, tin, lead are metals. So finally, we can see this table. So in this table, so all the properties, periodic properties are given, and how those periodic properties are changed in a groups and periods are mentioned here. So just if we observe this particular table, you can understand how the periodic properties are changing in every group and period. So example, see this example, valency, atomic radius, ionization energy, electron affinity, electronegativity, electropositivity, metallic nature, non-metallic nature, like that. So all the properties are given here.